Raine Island is a really small cay. It's located in the far northern section of the Great Barrier Reef, about 80 kilometres off the tip of Cape York. Raine Island is one of the largest rookeries in terms of the number of turtles that come ashore every year for green turtles in the world. The Raine Island Project has scientists involved from many different disciplines, and they are not only university scientists, we have Indigenous people with the Indigenous knowledge, we have government scientists and scientists from other institutions, all part of this larger project. The science disciplines, however, also vary. So we have disciplines including oceanography, biology, physics, chemistry, social science. All of these different disciplines have a role to play in terms of the Raine Island Project, the interventions that the government's placing on the island and the science that's being done there to try and understand the threats and also monitor the population. The turtles in Raine Island, they've got a few problems. The first problem is that the island is not supporting their nesting behaviour as well as it used to. So we've got areas of the island where the sand is too shallow for the turtles to dig their nests. We've got areas of the island where the nests are vulnerable to the water table rising or the overtopping of waves onto the island, and that's flooding the eggs.
So rather than just watching that continue over time, the decision was taken to try and do something about it. And the thing that was decided to do about it was to actually move sand around on the island to lift up the parts of the island that the turtles use for nesting. And rather than bring in sand from elsewhere, which could bring in a whole lot of problems like pathogens or diseases that could be harmful or could actually damage the reef and the corals around it, the decision was to use natural processes, much like what would happen in big storms, to transfer sediment from the beach back up into those low areas where the turtles nest. So we had to work out how much sand we could move, where we should move it from, and what times of the year we should move it at. And we did that by undertaking a whole range of analyses. So one of the things that was really critical to work out was how long it would take the organisms on the reef flat, which actually provide the sediment. The sediment is really just the bits and bobs of all their skeletons, how long that would take to replenish the material that we transferred from the beach back up onto the islands. And one of the things that many people don't know is when you go to a coral cay, the sand that's on the beach, the sand that makes up the island, isn't sand like you would find down on the mainland beaches. It's not derived from rocks. It is actually just the skeletal material, bits and bobs of the skeletons of all the organisms and plants and animals and corals that live out there. And on Raine Island, one of the really important things is that there's one particular organism, which many people know nothing about, that provides about 50% of all of the sediment that's on the island. And without that sediment, there's no turtles. So we had to work out how much of that material gets produced in a year, how long it takes to go from where it's being produced to the island. And then we could work out how much sand we could safely take from the beaches before, you know, it either caused problems which you didn't want to have, or before it would actually be able to recover from the sand that we've moved away.
What we've been able to do with the satellite tracking project is we can tell now where the turtles are nesting on the island. So we know that the turtles are nesting on and using those places where the sand profiles have changed and where the Queensland Government have placed their mitigation strategies. So we know that the turtles are using those new beach areas that have been constructed. We also know that they're not only using those areas, but they're successfully laying eggs into those areas, and it's taking them less time to lay eggs into those areas in terms of what the time spent on the beach, which is good because it saves them energy. The less energy a turtle takes to lay a clutch of eggs, the better. So we know that at least in that sense, those reprofiled or new areas on the island are actually going to work. Gradually, we're going to see more hatchlings being produced from those areas. Now, this is a longer term strategy, mitigation strategy, so it'll take a number of years for it to produce significantly more hatchlings. But season by season, we're showing gradual progress in the number of hatchlings that are coming off the beach and into the marine environment, which is a good thing.